Zen's price. We don't deserve this. We've done nothing wrong. I'm beginning to think our clan's just cursed. Driven from our home, then we find a new place to settle, only to have the very earth itself rise up against us? It's not fair. I'm from Clan Drilladan. Undead attacked our village weeks ago. We fled here and found this place just abandoned. No one here. It seemed perfect, so we settled in, and then these stone men, the Hollow, just burst from the ground and attacked. Yes, we're no strangers to battle, but these Hollow, they're unstoppable. Strike one down and another comes forth. Please, if you are as able as you look, Indana still fights to drive them back. She needs help, and fast. I wonder if you weren't sent by Ifrit herself. I hope so. We can't let these Hollow drive us away. We have to hold this ground. We have nowhere else to go. To the north, Drilladan Pass. Our clan has lived in that part of the Valenwood for longer than even our elders could remember. The Ultma came in and built Marbrook not long ago, but we stayed. Until the dead came. Hundreds of them. I don't know, and now that they're far behind us, I don't care. We've found a new home now. We must defend it or die trying.
Well met. If you're made of flesh and bone, I'm calling you a friend. These abominations, the Hollow, they've killed our Treefane and a dozen others. What in oblivion are they, and how do we get rid of them? Can you help us? I was afraid you'd say that. And all we know for sure is that the stony bastards are coming from the ground. I was thinking of trying to collapse their holes, but I need someone to defend me while I do it. What you say? Are you up for it? We're going where the holes are. There are a few big ones they're coming from. Collapsing them may not stop the Hollow completely, but hopefully it'll at least slow them down. If not, well, at least we'll go down fighting. You lead the way.
Free at last. My thanks.
Our clan's been through too much tragedy already. We lost our home and now our Treefane. Damn it, we're trying to start a new life here. We can't let these Hollows stand in the way of that. Like where? You want us to move into a city? You want us to move into Marbrook? Not a chance. We're true Treesap people. We live in Valenwood. We always have and we always will.
Ah! hail.
I'm free, and in your debt. Amazing to think you've been in the field with Tellinger himself! Simply amazing!
That should slow him down. Quickly, we should get to the clan holdfast.
Children of the forest, these grounds are forbidden to you. I warn you again, leave now or suffer the consequences.
We'll defend our new home to the dead. Come back here, you stony bastard!
Let us speak. I can explain what is going on.
Apparently, he wants to talk to you now. Some insanity about the health of the forest in his directives. I respect the Green Pact as much as the next Bosmer, but what he's talking about is something else entirely. Don't listen to him.
Perhaps you can be more reasonable than this, Bosmer. These grounds are forbidden. Allowing them to settle here would threaten the health of the Valenwood. If they do not leave, we will purge them with the forest like a destructive rot. No. There is no alternative. These people must leave. Know that this is not our will. We would not harm anyone of our own accord. We would let them stay. But our directives are not self-determined. They were ingrained when we were created. I do not know. We were created by the Wilder King. Perhaps these were his directives, or perhaps they just come from the forest. Regardless, we are here to ensure no one settles in this area. That is our only purpose. I must emphasize to both you and these Bosma that we did not desire this duty, nor did we take any joy in it. But we cannot act against our directives. The only way one might circumvent this is to destroy us, and that would be very difficult to do. Yes. It does not violate my directives to inform you that destroying me would effectively render all the Hollow in this area harmless. I have no desire for self-preservation, but know that such an act would do irreversible harm to the Valenwood.
I've never met the Wilder King, but I'm sure he wouldn't have created a bunch of monsters to indiscriminately kill innocent Bosma. Either way, my people have sacrificed enough already. We're staying here, even if that means we do so as corpses. Look, if you decide the stone abomination is right, and we shouldn't be allowed to stay here, I'll go back to the Clan Hovas and we'll take a vote. I warn you, though, the Drilladan are not a soft-skinned bunch. I think they'll choose to fight.
I must emphasize to both you and these Bosma that we did not desire this duty, nor did we take any joy in it. But we cannot act against our directives. The only way one might circumvent this is to destroy us. Yes. It does not violate my directives to inform you that destroying me would effectively render all the Hollow in this area harmless. I have no desire for self-preservation, but know that such an act would do irreversible harm. Very well, but my directives will make this difficult.
You're doing the right thing. Go destroy that bastard so my people can live here in peace.
Thank you.
Our scouts say the Hollow have stopped fighting. Some have crumbled into dust, others have simply wandered off. I trust this means you destroyed the Watchmen.
There's no way I can properly thank you for what you've done. This is the first good luck my clan's had in months. This means we can stay here and start over. Wherever you go, and whatever you do, you'll always be a champion of the Drilodon.
I have to admit, I do have some doubts now. But we'll petition the Wilder King for an audience. When he hears of our plight, I know he'll confirm that we can settle here. He'll make sure the wood is protected, too.
Is it over? We can stay. I almost find it hard to believe. Thank you, though. You have no idea how much.
There's never a wasp nest around when you need it. Stupid wasp. Keeps getting away from me. Shh! I'm an initiate to a company of hunters called the Hounds. I'm supposed to hunt a wasp as my first quarry, but I... Well, I'm not a very good tracker, you see. I've lost the wasp. Would you? I'd really appreciate it. To track the wasp, crouch low to the ground and look carefully. You can spot where the wasp has landed. Just look for matted grass or broken bushes. Track it, kill it, and bring me its head.
Thank you. Did you get it? Did you find the wasp? Fantastic! Well done! Of course, I can't exactly take credit for the kill, but I think I understand tracking better now that I've seen you do it. You're a natural. I once heard Ladrona talking about a great tracker named Horace from a long time ago. If I didn't know better, I'd think you were him. A legendary hound? He's obsessed with this mythical cinch, and his hunting companions often die. I heard he hunts in northern Greenshade.
Rest now, my love. It's all right. At least we're here.
It won't be long now. Even without the flowers, I'm glad we came. Being in this place, with Hartman, this is how I want my final moments to be.
Memories of youth are the treasures of old age. Savor them, and those who share them. They'll fade, but they're as sweet as sun's dusk ale while they last. Tongues of Xarxes, I sound like a pedantic old fool, don't I? Forgive me. Yes, ignore my nostalgic nonsense. It's just an attempt to pretend my musty past is worth something more than it is. Getting old isn't easy. My dear Marilia is passing. We came to see the flowers, but they don't seem to grow here anymore. I don't know. Nereid's Smile, they're called. So blue, so beautiful. There must be some nearby, but I'm too old to hunt them down. I wonder, though, if you see any, could you gather some seeds? I could sow them here for old time's sake. You are generous to humor two silly old men. But those seeds would mean so much to us. When we were young, we used to sneak away from the clan and come here to be together. Lying here among the Nereid's Smile, it seemed like we had forever. Not unless you can turn back time. No. To be honest, we've lived for many years more than either of us expected, but our time has finally come. Nothing can forestall my husband's death now, nor mine. Which I expect will follow soon after.
Do you know how to read? I am called Sumeril. I am one of the Hollow. We live to serve the Wilder King, who is our god, our creator. I ask you if you can read because I have this book, which is supposed to tell the true story of the Wilder King and of my creation. I can read it. But I am afraid to. I am not like the other Hollow. I can question my existence. I can believe or not believe. What if the book reveals something about the Hollow, our purpose? I might crack and splinter from within. It must be done, and I would be most grateful. You should know that who or whatever wrote this book bound it to the labyrinth. To traverse one, you need the other. This book holds a single passage only. The words for the next passage will appear once you have opened the book. Follow them. They will transport you to a point deeper into the labyrinth, then settle on the page and create another passage. I have roamed this land since before many of these trees were seeds. In that time, I have wanted to know how I came to be. Yet here you stand with the answer, and I hesitate, uncertain. I am unsure what I will regret more, knowing or never knowing the truth. Forgive my indecision. Please, continue. Mortal? Like you? What happened to me? Yet I live, don't I? Past, present, and future are stark, stripped of illusion, and I am left with more questions. I will have to find a new way to exist, neither living nor dead, neither doubting nor believing.
They're so beautiful, Hartman. Do you think they'll last forever?
It's all for us, Marilia. The forest. The flowers, all of it. Life is so precious and so fleeting. Don't let it pass you by. Take time to feel the caress of the wind and listen to the way it carries the sound of your true love's name. Marilia, I never did hear anything so sweet and so dear. Yes. His passing was quick and peaceful, and we were together. That's all that really mattered. Soon I will rest too. But you, you're so kind. Did you find the Nereid smile? It's funny. The flowers meant so much to us when we were young, but at the end, we didn't need the flowers anymore. We had the memories. These seeds are wonderful, though. I realize now their true significance. Goodbye, Marilia. I sow these seeds in memory of the life we shared. Even as we fade, may others come here and find the same joy we found in the flowers and in each other. So may our love be renewed for all eternity.